Hi, my name is Monisha. Today I'm going to be sharing a beauty haul. One of my most practical nerdy buys are these Pilot G2 Premium Gel Roller Pens. I journal every day and I do pre-plan my weeks just to get an idea of what I'm going to be doing, how much time I'm going to spend to do it. And I'm so happy because these are ultra fine 0.38 millimeter black ink pens. Personally, I do like writing in red ink. They're supposed to write super smooth, they're supposed to be very quick drying and refillable and have a comfort grip. I know this is the nerdiest thing in the world. I'm just so happy about these pens. I'm grateful for these pens because writing with really nice pens makes me so happy. This is Nail Envy Nail Strengthener with wheat protein and calcium. My nails are natural and they're starting to chip right here, so I wanted to get something that would build up the nail. I don't like acrylic nails just because once they're taken off, the natural nail is so damaged and I don't like that. I do want to have long, strong, beautiful nails, and my nails grow pretty quickly, and getting something that just takes care of them, love it. This is sort of practical. This is the Neutrogena Facial Cleansing Balm. I saw that people are doing soap brows where they take a spoolie, like a mascara spoolie or a brow spoolie, and they will rub soap on the spoolie and like brush their eyebrows upward. And that made me think, why not just do the same thing all over my face, you know, minus the brushing, unless I have a facial brush that I want to use. It just, for some reason, started to make sense to me to get a fragrance-free cleansing bar instead of using, let's say, a cleanser, some elaborate cleanser, going along and just using a regular cleansing bar. That would allow me to build up my soap brows and also clean my face. And it was like $5 for a pack of three, and this is something that's probably going to last me for the next probably 3 months. To treat the textured skin, I saw that using a chemical peel and an exfoliant is a good idea because textured skin is partially a result of dead skin cells, dead skin building up on the face, never being exfoliated, and that's why the skin starts to develop a texture. Also, drinking water is very helpful. I am drinking more and more water every single day. It is something that I have in my mind and I know that needs to be done. For now, along with the water, I did buy this Neutrogena Skin Glowing Facial Treatment. It is a weekly exfoliant, and I like that it's a weekly exfoliant because I understand if I use it too much, I'll probably damage, burn, peel in a very nasty way my skin. This has 15% AHA/PHA blend, which I imagine just helps with exfoliating. And because I will continue vlogging, you are going to see the effects of that. Another Neutrogena buy. And I understand this is really simple stuff. I was in the store and I was like, Neutrogena, I want to get something different. And Neutrogena is different for me because a lot of the time I buy my products from like Ross or don't get skincare products at all. So buying these Neutrogena products, which are also at Ross, was a pretty smart go. This is the Hydra Blues Glycolic Acid Overnight Peel. It has This is fragrance free and has hydrolic acid, which I like because it's going to help with making it look like my skin is moisturized. This is an overnight peel. This is the chemical peel that I need. This is going to exfoliate and smooth. So I'm hoping all these products together, especially because they don't have a fragrance, will be pretty light on my skin, even though it is, again, exfoliating and peeling. Using these over time, I'm hoping will give me the smooth skin that I am seeking. A few little boosters that were on sale are this hydrolic acid serum. this vitamin C serum, which I love vitamin C. Vitamin C has helped with clearing up a lot of my dark marks. I used to have a lot of dark marks just from scarring right here under the jaw, and vitamin C has significantly helped these dark marks go away. And also around the bikini line, I had dark marks from ingrown hairs, just picking at the ingrown hairs, trying to force them out and not going about it the proper way. Now with the vitamin C that I've been using, the area is starting to clear up and it's starting to look even and smooth, which is helping my confidence a lot. This lactic acid is also partially what I'm going to be using to support the exfoliation of my skin. I am not going to use all these things at the same time, and I'm probably going to monitor how they do on my skin, because I am not a dermatologist. I am an amateur when it comes to skincare. Something I also want to share is a realization that I came to while I was running. I run every single weekday for about 30 minutes, and within that time I usually finish about a mile or 2 miles. And while I was running, I realized that the trust issues that I have are dwindling significantly. I even almost said the trust issues I had, because I feel as though there has been so much growth in my life that trust issues aren't really what's taking the forefront of my mind, whereas at one point in time they were something that I struggled with a lot. I once was receiving help regarding those trust issues, and what's nice is the therapist I was seeing made the amazing point of, after the experiences you've had, yeah, that is that type of reaction, the feelings that you're feeling makes sense, which is very validating because it made me feel like, okay, you know, like there's not something wrong with me. There's perhaps something wrong with the scenarios that I've been in and how I respond to them moving forward is what helps me feel so much more trust within myself. I won't speak for everyone when I say this. This is purely an observation for myself. My trust issues, more often than not, were an issue with being able to trust myself. I think that a part of my inability to trust myself is because I present as a woman. Regardless of whatever gender identity I self-identify with, how I feel about myself, what I wake up and feel my soul is, when I walk down the street, the way that I exist gives off the vibes of woman. And that means that people are responding to me based off of what they're seeing. I've spoke to a few of my friends about this, and the idea of being a rich woman is something that is new to us to some extent. It seemed like a far off idea to be able to attain that. Traditionally, this idea of woman being rich because of man, or woman being with a rich man, or woman chasing a rich man, is something that has seemed so much more normal and common and realistic. It's gross to me personally, because that type of relationship creates a power dynamic where it seems a bit imbalanced. I want to be able to afford the life that I want to live, the world that I want to live in, the clothes that I want to wear, the furniture that I put in my home, and the home that I live in. I want to be able to be fully independent and have that confidence that I will always be able to provide for myself what I want. Because I was not able to do that when I was younger, and I also encountered a lot of people who were like, oh, you know, if you had a man, then you wouldn't have experienced some of the experiences you've had. And I also think that that idea is something that's just silently prevalent in multiple societies. So much so that it does tear at the self-esteem. At least it teared at my self-esteem. So I struggled with being able to trust because whenever anything bad happened to me, my response was, well, I should have known better and I should have been able to do this and should have been able to do that. The older that I get, the less likely I am to fall into those scenarios that make me feel like my trust is wavering, which does make me feel a higher self-esteem because now I recognize, actually, I'm pretty good at navigating the world now that I'm older and my brain is developed. Wild. Turns out when the brain's fully developed and the amygdala is able to make fully informed decisions, the way we discern what we're gonna do and who we're gonna do with it changes. Coming to the recognition that my issues with trust begin with my ability or inability to trust the people around me, to trust what I'm doing, to trust where I'm going, has changed everything. It's a paradigm shift. A paradigm shift that I recognize that I have way more control than I originally felt that I did. At one point in time, it felt like life was happening to me. At this point, it feels like, yeah, life is happening to me, and what I can manage, I manage. That confidence is life-changing, and that's just something that I have been able to go through the rest of my week with and know that yes, failure happens. Yes, sometimes I have to go back a few steps. Yes, there are decisions that I made in my youth that as an adult I wouldn't make in the same way or at all. That is growing. That is the process. I hope that these words and this video was calming or informative, helpful, inspirational, something. I hope that it was something if you're watching it. And perhaps you're just interested in knowing how I'm doing. And how am I doing? Today I'm doing well. And I hope that you have a wonderful rest of your day. And I will see you in the next vlog. What if I just started leaving like vlog? Vlog.